Hi there, welcome back. I recorded this footage 2 weeks ago. Let's try to remember what happened.
Well, I don't remember because I haven't seen it yet.
I forget everything after a week, so I'm going in blind. Who are we playing as again? Swery?
I think I'm Ethan Mars. I think we're looking for Jason. Why was that the reference that I made? Why is this the energy I'm bringing into this week?
One of the funniest things I saw on Wikipedia was, like, on the Heavy Rain Wikipedia page, they're describing, like, the different, like, context commands you can use, and it was, let's say, such as using the analog stick, you know, to open doors or closets, or pressing the X button to call the name of the main character's son, Jason.
Yeah. You press X to Jason.
God, that's an ancient meme.
It's metamorphotizing! I'm sorry?
I'm just thinking about how Ethan's theme is very clearly a ripoff of the Requiem for a Dream theme. Anyways, Big Boss Heartless.
Damn, I can't believe we're finally destroying the Disney castle.
It's about fucking time.
Isn't that Disney castle based on... God, was it Baron Ludwig, one of the castles he built?
I don't know. I thought it was just based on, like, the castle from, Cinderella.
But I think there's one thing we can agree on, is that it's not based.
I kind of really like these big boss fights, in the gummy ship.
Yep, I got it right. It is based on a castle built by King Ludwig the Second. So there is some history for you.
So, semi-interesting fun fact about the gummy ship segments of this game. If I'm remembering correctly, the lead designer, or, like, the heads of the gummy ship parts were the leads of, like, ship was a name called Swyhander. Which was, like, a Square Enix shoot-em-up RPG.
This is a really cool one. It's like a Metal Slug boss.
Yeah. I'm probably not going to show it off just because I'm probably going to forget about it. We'll see. But there is a gummy ship super boss, and it is just a boss from Swyhander. He plays like a remix of that theme.
Nice.
For that character.
Yeah, this is. I like how modular this boss is. It's a lot of fun.
Yeah, it's got like multiple phases.
And multiple faces.
This is really Metal Slug.
Where the fuck is Theo?
I was about to say put Theo in this game, you cowards.
Before we actually get to the world we're going to, hey, where do you think we're going based on this boss aesthetic?
Oh god, is it Frozen? Oh god, I didn't realize it was already time for Frozen.
Holy moly. Frozen 2 got released. I don't know anything about it other than the fact they tried to do Let It Go again with a new song.
Also, no, you fools, it's the Fox property Ice Age.
I'd be down. I'd super be down for that.
They've got a found family. They could do heart stuff.
I want Sora to become best friends with Sid the Sloth.
So, we've got 1.5 new Keyblades to show off.
Guess he's too used to the beach.
Hey, Islander, what can I say?
Why are you white?
Even the sea's turning to ice.
I mean, Asian probably, right?
Yeah.
Donald, this isn't your magic.
I mean, if he was from an island, would that make him... I suppose technically not. There are islands around Japan. It wouldn't be a Pacific Islander. Heartless?
Might be. Let's go.
Nondescript Islander.
Yeah.
Destiny Islander. Damn it. It's perfectly synchronized.
It's Disneylander.
Fuck off.
Wow, she running.
Wow, she really looks like she needs to let it go. The water, it's frozen.
Wow, the way she's moving, it looks like the cold doesn't bother her anywhere.
Suck.
I hate this bit. This bit sucks. Welcome to Arendelle.
I think you should Arendelle.
Jesus Christ. I wonder what happened. I was gonna make a Lord of the Rings maybe joke, the but
we should talk to her.
Do you think the Heartless are after her?
Worry not, Kara. We get the chest.
Good. One solace in this hell of an earth. This bitch of an earth.
Remember when everyone was convinced that Elsa would get a girlfriend in Frozen 2? And then everyone was surprised when Disney didn't fucking do that.
Remember when people kept expecting Disney to give them things?
Yeah.
Well, look, Disney's going to reveal their first gay character soon.
Yeah, it's Sora. Look,
no. So, I was talking about that. I see you've got the poo honey bukkake ability anyway. Now that the MCU has swallowed Deadpool, I fully expect Disney to say they've got the first LGBT superhero.
They would be wrong. Power Rangers 2017 beat them to that.
When the fuck has that ever stopped Disney from lying about their non-existent LGBT rep?
You know what? Fair. So, the reason I said we have 1.5 new Keyblades is because the 100 Acre Wood Keyblade is just a reskin of the Shooting Star that's slightly stronger. Which is why we're still flying around doing all the shoot 'em up shit.
If I knew anything about like video editing, maybe I should ask Rai. I want to get all the parts of this LP where the bitrate got tanked by that one attraction and have Guts theme set over it.
Honestly, this is probably the last episode you're going to see me using either this or the Shooting Star. I don't really care for those Keyblades.
That's fine by me. I kind of hate these honey glorp noises.
Yeah. That's what good honey sounds like, Kara.
Oh, I don't even know where to go after that. Good lord.
We're back, folks.
We are back.
The cursed Winnie the Pooh energy continues on with this episode.
Did you just not expect that when you equipped the Winnie the Pooh Keyblade?
It kind of wasn't.
Should I go over to my fridge? I've got alcohol in there.
Anyways, here's our actual, like, fully new Keyblade, the Happy Gear.
Mm.
It is my favorite Keyblade in the entire game because of its transformations.
Anyway, these deer heartless are weirdly upsetting looking.
Hmm.
I think it's the necks.
They do got that neck, though.
Yeah, it's the necks and the way they kind of, like, bounce around when you hit
them. Yeah.
Good lord, I just held on to that transformation, huh?
Here we go. There it is. Ooh.
Yeah, so we get like super fast agility claws.
Wow. Nice. Sora's got power fists. Yeah.
My god, he's a Gundam.
And we get a second transformation.
Do you go from agile claws to, like, strong claws or something?
I mean, you can just see in the command menu down there. But I have waited until I actually use the damn things.
I think Sora would know how to walk the dog and nothing else with yo-yos. Okay, that was kind of rad looking.
Yeah, the shot locks in this game are great, especially that one. I love just teleporting my attacks to the enemies.
Seems cool. I love this new Heartless type that's just divorced Ice Bitch. Just whom have laser.
I think it's a reskin of one of the characters from the, or one of the Heartless.
It is,
but the aesthetic is very good.
The ice aesthetic's very good,
I do wish they stood out a little more visually because they're dark blue and, like, dark white and blue.
Yeah. Yeah, I am enjoying the winter divorcee Heartless.
Definitely doesn't keep her dead husband's body in the freezer.
The perfect crime. Bludgeoned her husband to death with a lamb chop and then cooked it and fed it to the police.
Well, at least it was a lamb chop and not a pork chop, otherwise it'd be cannibalism.
Anyways, here's our twin yo-yos.
Oh, hell yeah.
Except I don't actually really get to use
them.
Damn it. Thank God we could store the transformations.
What are the spinny sword things in the ground?
They're kind of highlights to tell you, hey, go this way, and also if you hit them, you get a little bit of money.
Mm.
They're the fucking bonfires that Elsa has planted.
God, Kingdom Hearts, but it's souls.
I'd be down. The more I get on it, I'll play it.
Hell yeah, I'm down to see Aqua hang out with Priscilla the crossbreed.
Why are you here? Where did you come from?
Hi, I'm Sora.
It's a shame that Kingdom Hearts doesn't have, like, any hilariously anime fan service designs because it's a game for kids. Because I was going to try and make an Amazing Chest Ahead joke, but, like...
I think that'd be Terra, honestly. I'm goofy.
Are you visiting Arendelle for the coronation?
You got us. So, what's your name?
Elsa. Queen Elsa of Arendelle.
What? The queen?
Oh, now he stands at attention.
You shouldn't be out here. Please go back to the village.
Why? Your Majesty... You look like you could use a friend. Don't you want to talk?
Please leave. I need to be alone. I don't want to hurt anyone.
Oh. Is it that bad? You must have been through a lot.
We know what that's like, don't we?
Sure, adventuring's fun, but it definitely has its ups and downs. When the going gets tough...
Yeah, like, playing the Dungeons and Dragons adventuring has its downs there.
Exactly. Donald, you do lose your temper a lot, so I can relate to wanting some alone time.
Damn. Fucking got him.
Whoa!
Oh.
Almost killed our boy.
Elsa, did you...
The Heartless.
What? Jesus.
How fucked up would it be if the Dear Heartless were just Bambi? Like, that's just the form they decided to take.
It'd finally be the sequel. Bambi on the PS2.
Yeah, in retrospect, I'm surprised that we didn't actually get Bambi out of in the Kingdom Hearts game.
Yeah.
I think Bambi's a summon in one of them. I can't remember which one. It's either one or two.
Mm.
What happens is Bambi's mom die and everyone gets depressed.
No, Hunter comes out and shoots the enemy.
Unfortunately, the only summons from the second game I remember off the top of my head are Stitch and Chicken Little.
Ugh.
Anyways, here's the twin yo-yos.
I've never...
They're kind of like grappling hooks, almost. They're super long-range melee attacks.
Yes, they're
the
very
chains
cool.
of Olympus.
I just realized the worst joke I could possibly make or reference to make these. They're like the Blades of Chaos. That animation was absolutely rad. Hop on.
I love to not be able to see the timing.
Yeah, that big boy getting in the way. What the hell going on?
It sure is, buddy. semi-interesting fun fact, you can actually buy the Monsters, Inc. Yo-yos off the Square Enix store. Maybe don't go through the Square Enix store? Professional tip from your buddy Austin?
You've had a very good time with getting a pre-order revoked, haven't you?
Heard anything back on that?
Yeah, I got my money back like 2 days ago.
Oh, okay, good. I know they put you through hell, though.
I got my money back like 2 days ago and probably went to see the Green Knight, so like, worth it, honestly.
I like this Heartless's, like this helmet's little barriers.
Yeah.
Oh my god, I never noticed the little barriers before, that's so good.
It's super fucked up that grizzly bears are like, so monstrously dangerous, but they were created with such cute ears.
It's fucked up.
This guy is taking a bit of a beating.
Yeah, it's kind of a mini boss, but it's a weird time to put a mini boss into this level. Because we're like 10 minutes into actually playing it.
Elsa, are you okay?
I'm sorry I was so upset. Thank you for your help.
Oh no, watch out.
Look out!
Ooh. Oh.
Elsa has tasted blood.
That's amazing.
You can She's unstoppable ice. Now.
Control it? No, all I ever do is hurt people.
But what if you hurt the right people?
I'm assuming they didn't get Elsa's voice actress for this.
They did!
They did! Wow. I did not. I assume they wouldn't be able to.
They're after people's hearts?
Yes. And it's a very good thing that they did. You should head home before it gets because certain scenes of this would not work very well with a different person.
Is she gonna sing?
I don't want to hurt anyone.
I can neither confirm nor deny. I
think she's gonna sing. I think we're gonna get a copyright claim on this episode.
Not safer for you!
You say that, but this video has been uploaded for like 2 weeks of raw footage. Wise, and I haven't gotten shit.
I think every episode that is now going to get claimed is any episode I made a Warhammer 40k reference in.
Yeah. There's animation in this game, so it counts as a fan animation now. Like
Games Workshop will bring the hammer down on Austin. The Warhammer.
Damn it.
Yeah.
Oh, fuck you, Donald. Yeah, I just realized what he said. I just wanted to know why she was such a piece of shit, Doug.
And how is it any of your business?
Huh? Oh, no.
Oh!
It's her next-gen Larsine.
She's here to fuck shit up. Code.
You knew?
Excuse me? Oh yeah, you forgot. The name's Larsine. This time remember.
Yeah, that's her. She's stolen Axel's catchphrase. She has cooked his catchphrase from him.
Hit him with the RKO.
Well, she seems to think she knows us, so maybe we should play along.
Like seeing her that Disney didn't give Elsa a girlfriend, now she's here to force Disney to make her Elsa's girlfriend.
Why are you after Elsa?
No one's gonna hurt her, but we're not about to put up with your meddling. Stay here and behave yourselves.
Oh my god. She's so powerful.
This is the power of being a wine mom.
Like, she's just gonna, like, root around in the snow and pull out some bottles of vodka she's just, like, stashed in a snowdrift.
The ice!
It's going to wall us in!
Ice is so not my style.
Loxine still has it. By has it, I mean owning children.
Absolutely. We stand.
She hasn't suplexed a child yet.
She has entombed whatever the hell Sora is.
We can't stay in here.
Young adult? I think he's supposed to be like 17, 18 at this point.
Entombed a teen.
I trust those guys as far as I can throw them.
Definitely still only 5'3".
He's a manlet.
That is simply how it is.
Yeah, we'll freeze if we don't find a way out.
And just think, you two are wearing clothes that used to be in cold areas.
Goofy also has fur. I don't know what the fuck he's complaining about.
Try this!
Does this mean it sucked this whole time for Sora anytime he's had to, like, use Blizzard magic?
God, imagine how fucked it up if, like, that magic did affect you. Imagine how fucked up it is to go from Blizzard to fire magic immediately.
You ever put a ceramic mug, like, on top of a cold surface after putting boiling water on it or in it?
No, but I know exactly what happens if you do.
Yeah, I've also seen Final Destination 1 like 12 times. And that, friends, is how you get a knife in the stomach. What?
Final Destination was very stupid, occasionally in a good way. Some of the sequels were stupid in a bad way.
Yeah, 1, 2, 5, and parts of 3 are good. 4 is, like, terrible. Yeah.
Some of the kills in, like, Final Destination 2 that they got, like, the lead stunt guy to work on were incredibly good.
Yeah, you can tell if anybody has watched Final Destination 2 based on how willing they are to drive behind a log truck.
Fuck, yeah, that initial scene is so fucked up. I still get nervous if I see a log truck. I'm also impressed by how many practical effects there were in that movie.
Yeah, people actually died.
Yeah.
The original actor for Kratos was in that movie, too.
Oh, yeah, he is. Doesn't he get his head completely, like, smashed between those exercise things?
No, you're thinking that that's,
mix that up, yeah.
No, I forget how he goes out in 2, but he's, like, the one black guy in the movie is the best way to put it.
Oh, I remember, they have that scene where he tries to shoot himself just to get it over with, and Death won't allow the gun to fire because Death's killing them in order.
Right. Yeah, he's also in the elevator scene.
Oh, yeah, that one.
Anyways, I will not be getting that chest that I looked at because I could not figure it out. I'm pretty certain I need double jump to get it, and we don't have double jump yet.
Motherfucker.
Why didn't you just do speedrun strats to get it and then return?
Yeah, because I'm good enough at this game to do speedrun strats.
Yeah.
To find your final destination.
Here we go. What the heck? Oh, yeah, I see. You were just activating that and it didn't pop up from a different angle.
Yeah, sometimes it doesn't do the whole cinematic angle if the camera's in a weird spot.
Who are these, like,
sort of
Chad Chaos Warrior Heartless?
These Barrowmen.
Yeah. Reskins of the big, like, horse minotaurs or whatever. Horse. From
minotaurs are bulls, Austin. Yeah. Horses don't have horns.
Sure. The big monsters from Olympus.
Do you imagine if horses had horns though? That'd be fucked up.
Yeah. They're already dangerous. Why would you need to give them those?
Isn't that just a unicorn?
I mean, like, bull horns.
Yeah.
Oh.
Unicorns are, like, more of a horse narwhal, and a narwhal's more of a whale unicorn.
Yeah. Unicorns are also deeply fucked up, but in a different way.
Yeah.
Unicorns for when you want to get impaled by a horse. For when you want to get impaled by a horse in a different way.
Oh god, I wasn't going to be the one to make the joke.
Thank you, Austin.
We were thinking it.
We all know that mythology. If you don't ask us to explain it.
Real Craig 2 high voltage. Hours go.
Children should not be viewing this LP to begin with.
No, absolutely not. If you're a minor and you're watching this, I mean, number one, stop. But two, if you didn't get what we were just talking about, ask your parents.
Yeah. Also, don't call us out on Twitter because you watched our content.
You ever think about how the Teen Titans Go movie, like, literally ends with Robin being like, no, the movie can't end yet, and then he just yells at the kids in the theater, ask your parents how babies are made!
The kind of weird contempt that series has for its viewers is interesting.
Hey, look! We can get through now! And I think it opened when Sora rotated that pillar!
The pillars are here for revenge now.
Time for some magic! Yeah!
An interesting noise from Goofy.
He's kind of Crash Bandicooting it. Whoa, Sora!
Wonder what Goofy's opinion on Wumpa Fruit is.
What would be worse, Goofy like Mickey or sounding like Crash Bandicoot, or Crash Bandicoot sounding like Goofy?
I think Goofy sounding like Crash Bandicoot would be worse.
Yeah. Yeah! Yeah! Just make Goofy's origins more racist.
Oh yeah, I forgot Goofy's entire origin was kind of unbelievably racist.
I don't know what y'all are talking about, and I'm just gonna say, let's move on.
Racism, it's what's for dinner.
We do. We do not talk about Disney's past. We also do not talk about Disney's present or future. We should simply consume product and then look forward to the next product.
Jesus, what are you? Why, yes, I am looking forward to the rest of What If. Why do you ask?
I'm looking forward to when Shang-Chi comes out and then Marvel MCU fans are going to pretend that it invented Asian martial arts movies.
That spin trick you did should work again.
Gosh, Sora, use the power of the spin.
Sora, do a barrel roll.
Sora, fire off your fingernails. Gorsh!
Sora, you gotta work out the golden ratio. A yuck.
Sora, have you ever heard of Ice Nine?
I hear it kills.
For reference, I mentioned that an Ice Nine song came on the radio and I described them as the most theatre kid band possible. And then Austin went and listened to them and enjoyed it.
Is that really so surprising, considering the rest of the nonsense I listen to in my life?
True. You are indeed the world's end girlfriend enjoyer.
Let's see.
Nice picture, Sora.
That said, I have listened to a song that Will's end girlfriend worked on. It was a song by Millie, who did the music for Library of Ruina.
There might be something up there.
I need to play more of that game. Its console port is...
I cannot imagine playing that on anything other than PC, because even the PC's hard to navigate on.
Yeah, there's a lot of menus, and you gotta LBRB a lot.
Yeah. Yeah, Millie make good, interesting music, because their songs are either like, oh, we're going to invent an entire like fantasy setting to write a song about. It's either that, or it's just the singer writing about their fucking sandwich order. I shit you not, they have a song entirely where the lyrics are just entirely about meatball submarines. They also
Kiba Mato or however that's pronounced.
Yeah, they also inexplicably made the music like the opening and like image song for Goblin Slayer, which we won't go into detail on.
Oof.
But yeah, they did the opening song and some of like the battle theme to Library of Ruina, and it's very good.
Here we go.
The animation for that is really good.
Yeah, I really like the twin yo-yos. They're fun to use in both like gameplay wise and animation wise.
Mm.
It all comes together in a way that's.
Also, well, you've been talking about how good their range is. You missed a lot of those strikes.
Yeah, because the enemy kept, like, moving right out of the way or becoming invincible for a second.
Stand still so I can shoot you with my gun.
Why does spinning on a pillar do that?
I like to think Sora figured it out by accident because he just saw a pillar and wanted to spin on it.
It really feels like this game has like more ideas than it knows what to do with sometimes. Like those grinding segments are kind of neat, but they either go on for, like, not long enough, or there's nothing to do with them. Like the one in Olympus, where you just are on it for 20 seconds and you have nothing to do but watch Sora go forward.
Oh yeah, I forgot about that. I'm reminded of the magic carpet segment from Kingdom Hearts 1's Aladdin World, where you can just put the controller down.
Yeah, I was gonna say, you mean the one where I literally put the controller down and just let it go?
I also did that when I ended up playing that.
It gives you more health points than you would reasonably lose taking damage from everything.
I think the opposite of that kind of sequence is I played Crisis 3. And there's an on-the-rails sequence at the end where you cannot aim for shit. With a mouse, the aiming reticule is like five... It lags behind wherever you're aiming by 5 seconds. And once something passes like a certain part of your field of vision, you cannot hit it. And guess what? You can die in that section very easily if you miss one ship. So I never completed Crisis 3.
Yeah, I wouldn't either.
Lock everything into place.
I agree with you, Donald, for once. I'm sure you'll say something that'll make me hate you again in a minute.
Yeah.
Just give him a hot second.
Oh, hell yeah, it's an orb. This game needed a few more orbs.
This day keeps getting better and better.
What?
So I got a little bit lost here, realized, oh, I went the wrong way, and
there we go. 3 seconds of gameplay well spent.
Okay, you see a big orb and you don't touch it? What's wrong with you?
Well, you think you're like, oh, this is where the game wants me to go, so I've got to explore.
I think she might have gone up in that direction.
What?
Okay, come on!
I was a weird about it, standing still. This is some real, like, Christmas music.
It is, yeah. You know what that kind of reminded me of, the first few notes? All I want for Christmas is you. Oh, fucking Christ. We're getting close to October, I'm like, due to COVID and everything, we're going to start hearing Christmas songs, like, as soon as Halloween ends.
Yeah.
Man, I feel like I'm hearing Christmas music at, like, the end of September.
Yeah.
Probably.
There's been, what, like, 1,000 Christmas songs. Not one of them is a banger.
Didn't the Killers release a song, like, a Christmas song about how Santa Claus shot somebody's mom?
I don't know about that.
Whoops. Austin? Nope. Okay, good.
No, go back to the orb. Touch it, touch it, touch it.
Caress the orb. Anyway, I can see why you got turned around here. It's very samey looking. A whole lot of white and grey. Yeah. Oh boy.
Back off! Back off!
I mean, thankfully, these are just, like, little dudes who hardly even attack.
They're just little pot heartless. They have 5 money on them and a short sword.
I've heard of pot money, but this is ridiculous.
It's like Link always said.
Damn it, were you trying to make a I got 5 on it joke?
No, I was making a joke about drugs.
Well, no, I know that, but I'm saying that's still Yagi.
I was not, no.
Okay, because I thought that would have been the significance of having 5 money for
points. No, it was a reference to a Leon tweet, where it said, I'm just like a level 1 goblin in a cave. I have 5 gold pieces and a short sword on me.
Wait, why is this not the way to go?
It's because you need to go back to the orb.
You have disrespected the orb and it has locked your gameplay progress.
So, the first time I played this level, I got lost. You have to flow motion up here.
That's weird, because
I think you never have to do to progress before
this. No, I was about to say, that's the first time flow motion's been like a real thing for moving, because they've nerfed it so much.
I would really like them to kind of try and do the parkour stuff again. Because, like, I'm not saying that it's bad in this game. It's just, like, I feel it needs to be a way for you to get around fast and be more risk-reward. Because you're also, like, invincible while you're doing it.
Yeah, it feels like they made it too powerful and now they're scared of it.
How did I miss that hidden Mickey?
Oh, here we fucking go.
Is this like an entirely new recording of it?
Nope!
My neighbor's daughter used to play this song and like do karaoke to it, which was fine. She just had an absolutely uncanny ability to pick when I was recovering from a migraine to do so.
Heaven knows I what?
I hate that I've only seen this movie once. But I know this song almost word for word because they would not stop fucking playing this song everywhere.
Oh yeah, same.
And I also think I did it in high school choir once. Because I just couldn't escape it, I guess.
This sure is just this song.
Yeah. Yep.
Like, we have... It's not archive footage. We have remade the Let It Go scene, except Sora, Donald, and Goofy are here now.
I have heard this described as Let It Go, but Sora, Donald, and Goofy are there. That's literally what it is. It's funny
how some distance... You think Sora, Donald, and Goofy are like... Goofy's like, why is this bitch singing, Sora?
Gosh, at least we're not back in Atlantica.
Sora, she's gone insane.
She killed that one Heartless and now she's losing it. She's going feral.
This really feels like them just kind of like flexing and going like, look at what we can do in this video game in real time. Because, like, admittedly, this does look pretty similar to the actual movie.
And there's the other thing that it's paining me to admit is this song is legitimately fucking catchy as hell.
Oh yeah, it's good.
Did Lin-Manuel Miranda write this song?
Oh god, I hope not.
Possibly. Lin-Manuel Miranda does unfortunately write catchy songs, even if he's a horrible, horrible little man.
No, it was written by Christian Anderson Lopez and Robert Lopez.
He did all the music for Moana, though.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking of, Moana.
Yeah.
This reminds me that I kind of wanted to see In the Heights, but I haven't yet. The past is in the past. Because unlike the rest of the world, I don't fully hate Lin-Manuel Miranda.
Being fair, I'm in the minority, being a cynical socialist. I still got an owned because I got tickets for my mum to see Hamilton and I have to go as well.
I think he makes good music. I just think he's kind of a bad performer.
He is the weakest performer in Hamilton. And that is made very clear by the fact he has to perform with absolutely phenomenal actors.
Yeah, when you've got David Diggs, like, holy shit.
I don't know what we just saw. I don't know what we just saw either, Sora. Fuck it, man. It's Kingdom Hearts 3. And the one
happier, too. Gosh, maybe we should leave her to be an ice hermit. Let's say hi.
Carrie, you say that in the exact cadence of, like, sure, Peggle blast to make phone calls, nothing matters anymore.
Larkzine is here!
Don't turn this around on us. You're following her.
Ooh, look at you get all sassy. Okay, I'll admit, Elsa is a person of interest to us. Maybe she's one of the 7 pure lights we need. The new 7 hearts. Sure, though. Fortunately, we're in the best position to tell.
7 new princesses of heart, I guess.
Unless you're standing in the shadows. And maybe Elsa doesn't
like,
have it. I mean, just look how icy her palace is.
Rapunzel, magic she Elsa.
Keep hidden until now. What if it's
this music cool. Is a bit epic this for this conversation.
Actually, we got Rapunzel, we got Elsa, we got Woody.
It was Buzz, actually. I think he was the one who got corrupted by darkness, so maybe it's Buzz.
Right, I forgot about the Buzz Lightyear corruption arc.
I hate the reality where Tim Allen is a princess of heart.
Darkness. I know. I want to know.
I'm glad Larkzine is still as powerful as ever.
I won't let her fall to darkness!
It's her choice to make, not yours. You gave you the cold shoulder.
Oh, that cut off a bit weirdly.
Yeah. weird.
Galaxian is one of the only members of Organization 13 who realizes their fucking elemental powers can do other shit.
Well, being fair, everybody else's elemental powers, like puddles, Sakura blossoms.
Galaxian has a functioning understanding of electricity. I can fuck with weather patterns with this.
Now they're dead. They're just fucking dead.
This is the second time we have fallen off a cliff in this world. We are on episode one of this world.
Stuck in the snowdrift tag.
Gorsh, help me.
Yeah, you gonna finish that?
Gorsora, help me, I'm in hell.
Me too, man. We should probably go
check on Elsa. I'm sure Larxene was wrong about her magic.
Yeah.
But don't you tell her what Larxene said.
Huh? Why not?
Well, to keep the order.
Yeah, order.
Oh, okay.
Sure, that makes sense.
Oh, wait, fellas. Do you hear that?
I do like how cartoony they can get with Donald and Goofy now.
Yeah, I'm exceptionally excited to see how they start transitioning this into, like, more now that we've also got the next-gen systems.
Yeah.
Did Larxene send this avalanche, or is it purely incidental?
A little bit of column A, a little bit of column B.
Because I was about to say, if Larxene's actually smart enough to try and finish the fucking job after throwing him off this cliff.
She's the smartest member of Organization 13, and that's why they had to try and snuff her out early.
They
cannot... hate to see a girl boss winning.
Exactly. Took the words right out of my mouth.
Anyways, welcome to some Crash Bandicoot bullshit.
I can't wait until you fall off the shield and have to jump on a baby polar bear. I like these heartless designs. Are they heartless or are they unversed, actually?
Yeah, these are heartless. Yeah.
They look like some silly boys.
They do.
This segment goes on for a bit too long.
I like that this is called the Trinity Sled.
Yeah. It's the sled they use in the Matrix.
Oh wow, you are taking some hits. What the hell was that, Donald? Is there any way to recover?
Donald's just doing like vocal exercises. Just got used to the game.
Is there any way to heal, or are you just screwed if you get too many hits?
Just screwed. The only thing we can do is move left and right and jump.
Oh boy!
This feels surprisingly PS2 for this PS4 game.
It does.
Yeah, like I said, it's some Crash Bandicoot bullshit.
Not good Crash Bandicoot bullshit either.
There hasn't been a Nitro block to be seen.
Also, the music in this level or this part is really boring.
It is, yeah. Why was the music so good while Larxene was just talking?
What the fuck is going on now? Okay.
Now I have played some Sonic Adventure music, so there's some energy to this shit.
Jesus Christ.
He couldn't even put City Escape.
No, because I put the snowboarding theme from Sonic Adventure 1, you heathen!
I haven't played that game.
Kara has multiple girlfriends, she has not played Sonic Adventure 2.
We let's played Sonic Adventure 2, and I don't even remember it.
God, am I going to have to put Sonic Adventure 1 on the list of games to LP after we do Riders, eventually?
Yeah, when the fuck are we doing Riders? Woody was just in my house for, like, a month.
Yeah, but I didn't want to do it, because, like, editing both of you on one microphone was going to be hell. Yeah.
Alright, we did talk about that, but now she's home.
Yeah. Soon, trademark.
Once this, I've mentioned before, but once this LP is done, Austin is going to entomb me in a crypt. He's going to put the nuclear warning sign up here, informing everyone that there is no virtuous deeds to be found there. This is not a place of honor.
I need one of those signs so I can slap it on my ass. This is still going on.
Yeah.
At one point, I was thinking about teaching myself a bit of video editing so I could do an LP of the Warhammer Space Marine game, but I realised I probably will get sued if I attempted to do so now. For a bit of reference to this and the other Games Workshop reference, they updated their IP rules, and they've banned all fan animations and a bunch of other stuff under legal threat, so the fandom is dying in its own way. And I do not have the time or inclination to get sued by Games Workshop. Oh, you can cut the wings off.
Nice. And also maybe evil.
And now this is a true Monster Hunter game. Just need
to... So I've mentioned this more than a few times, but I've always been surprised that, like, Union Cross is just a mobile game. Like, and it's a gacha-ass thing. So, and eventually, that app is gonna be impossible to use on stuff. So it's kind of surprising to me that they didn't try to turn it into, like, a Monster Hunter-style thing, because that's basically all you do in that game. You load into an area, you run around, and you fight a couple of Heartless, and then you beat the boss, and you finish the mission.
Well, if it was a Monster Hunter-style game, the grind would be different, and there'd be less incentive to spend money on it.
Well, yeah, but, like, they shut down the gacha stuff now. Like, that game has gone offline.
God, I did see someone, I might have to, like, link you to it, but I saw someone who does, like, Fate Grand Order translations, and they have, like, a full archive of the Union Cross translations they did.
I mean, I know more or less what happens throughout all of Union Cross. I'm just saying, it's like, I was under the assumption that at some point they were going to try and do something with that plot as, like, a console game, but I guess not. Anyways, now we can double jump.
Also, I just realized what these silly dragon boys remind me of. They kind of look like Bionicles.
Hmm. Yeah, I can see where you're getting... I can see that, yeah.
Well,
third time we've got off a cliff in this episode.
Wow, look at all the pretty colors. There's blue and green. Ooh, I love green. And look, black. Ah, just like my buttons.
Just realized who this is, and I'm mad.
Silly spiky grass. Give me back my foot.
Wasn't there some weird controversy about this snowman?
Was that?
Yeah, because there was snowman? Some Disney movie, they put like a 20-minute Olaf short in front of it, and everybody was complaining because they wanted to watch the Disney movie, not the 20-minute long Olaf short.
They really...
Nobody wants to watch Olaf for that long.
Yeah, exactly. So, I guess that's what we're doing next episode.
Oh, man. Hey, Austin, put up a picture of that one Olaf shirt where someone cut off the end so it just says, I like war.
Sorry, what? I got distracted because I was thinking about Count Olaf as played by Jim Carrey doing the dinosaur shit. Series of Unfortunate Events movie is not good, but I love it.
And then the unthinkable happened.
So, the way they pushed Olaf so hard as a mascot makes me think of... There was a Disney on Ice show, and the show ended when I was heading home from work. So the train was filled with 70 Elsas.
Oh boy. Well, see you next time, folks.
Oh, fuck, there's more of this.